皆様大変お待たせいたしました。それではオープンデータシンポ
ジウム2014 Thank you very much for waiting. We would like to start Open Data Symposium 2014 and the subtitle is Now that Open Data is Available, Let's make better use of it. The role our society plays in regional revitalization. The first portion of this program is to introduce the new corporation.Called VLED, that is Vitalization Local Economy Organization by Open Data and Big Data. Now we would like to have a greeting from the Ministry of Internal Affairs and Communications, Mr. Sakurai. Thank you very much for attending this symposium despite your very busy schedule. On behalf of the Ministry of Internal Affairs and Communications, I would like to celebrate the opening of VLED, and I would like to extend my sincere gratitude to those who have made much effort to build this. And also, we are very happy to have the presence of Mr. Endo and Mr. Tomita from the Cabinet Secretariat, as well as METI.
オープンデータの取り組みとまさに手についたばかりだったわけでございます。以来2年半にわたりまして、産学官のまさに連携の拠点としてワークのオープンデータ戦略を利用していただいてきたということでございます。具体的にはオープンデータの技術使用の策定でありますとか、あるいは利用ルールの策定、あるいは自治体アプリ関係者に対する普及啓発活動など積極的なお取り組みをいただいてきたわけでございまして、コンソーシアム設立にはオープンデータに取り組む、オープンデータに取り組む自治体はほとんどまだ見当たらない状況だったわけでございますけれども、今や150を超える自治体が積極的に取り組んでいただいているところでございます。また政府のデータポータルサイトに掲載されているオープンデータのデータセット数も1万2000ということでございまして、世界各国と比べても遜色のない水準になってきているということでございます。今般こうした取り組みの一層の強化、あるいは組織基盤の強化ということを目指して、この一般社団法人化が行われたわけでございますけれども、その際には従来のオープンデータに加えてビッグデータのいろんな取り組みというものも視野に入れ、かつオープンデータ、ビッグデータを活用して新しいサービス、新しいビジネスを喚起して地方創生にも貢献するといった活動の拡大が盛り込まれたところでありまして、まさに時期を得たものだなというふうに思っている次第でございます。総務省といたしましても政府の一員として
密接に関係をしているというのも思っています。この社団が with this organization, so that with the three-party cooperation, private, public, and academia, I'm sure that we'll be able to build a very good strategy with the people of this VLED, including Mr. Sakamura. And I would like to hope for further progress of this organization. Thank you very much for your attention.
続きまして、ご来賓の方々よりご挨拶を頂戴したいと存じます。
初めに内閣官房内閣情報通信政策官遠藤浩一様です。それでは遠藤浩一、
The government CIO of the Cabinet Secretariat and National Strategy Office of Information and Communication Technology。
Thank you very much for the introduction. I'm also having some difficulty to say the heading the National Strategy Office of Information Communication Technology and Government CIO. And this the new organization is also having a long name.
as Mr. Sakurai has said, we are joining the hands with the METI as well as the MIC to promote the open data usage. And from October the 1st, we started to have the complete version of the site, and we have the rules and also the usage were decided. And we used to have an open data promotion consortium, and then that was changed into the virtualizing local economy organization by open data and big data as of October the 14th. And it is a great pleasure to have this inauguration. As you can see in the name of this new organization, the local economy vitalization is one of the most important themes of the current cabinet office. Of course, we would like to see the revitalizations of the regional towns, the peoples, and the job market. I hope that this open data will make a contribution to that. And not only the central government, but the local governments are also involved in the promotion of the open data. We are receiving the involvement of the rural and the local communities. We need to join the hands with the industry, and we have various the business representatives as well as the NPOs, like those attending today, who are cooperating with us. And in the end, I hope that this open data promotion activities, which is conducted by the Japanese government, and we started the final the website as of October the 1st, and 12,000 data sets, or such the huge data sets are included. And also, there is a ranking of the e-government by UN, and it is announced that every 2 years. And previously, we used to be at the rank of 18th or 16th. But because of this open data project, the e-government promotion is also conducted at the Japanese government. And now Japanese government ranked at the number 6. When we ranked at number 16 or 18, we were always criticized. And now at the number 6, they do not believe the data at all. But I think this organization and the website and the various efforts has probably borne the fruit, and we are already at the front of the race. We would like to continue these type of activity so that we can keep these position. Thank you very much.
Thank you,
Mr. Endo.
Next, we would like to hear from the
Ministry of Economic Trade and Industry, the Office Manager of the Commercial Information Policy, Mr. Kensuke Tomita.
Everyone,
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm the top of the Commercial Information Policy Office at the MLT. My name is Tomita. Thank you very much for inviting me to the announcement of the opening this organization called the Vitalizing Local Economy Organization by Open Data and Big Data and a contribution to everybody involved here. With this open data era, the various data owned by the local government and also the central government will be published so that it will be used effectively, and so the not only the quality improvement but also the usage of the data, and the this should serve our infrastructure for the innovations. As Mr. Sakurai, as well as the, Mr. Endo had said, the national governments are now trying to promote the usage of the open data. We used to have the Open Data Promotion Consortium, and that has also made a lot of achievement. And the local communities are also publicizing their data to the public, and the various the applications are also emerging for the public service, but it has just started to create the business using such data, open data, and we would like to move ahead so that we can come up with some innovations from these type of the data. And also, the open data and big data's the positions or the roles to play in the local economy will be very important. So we'll join hands with the academia as well as the industry to produce the data which would be usable, and technology infrastructure for usage of such open data and big data needs a collaboration, and we need a common data structure, the words and the phrases to be used and shared for this initiative. And we would like to create those new businesses utilizing data. And we would like to support such type of activities. We have also witnessed some of the organizations emerging from these initiatives, and also the good ideas and entrepreneurs should be also matched. And those are the also the area that we would like to work on. And in the end, I hope that the this new organization, BLED, would prosper, and also the your achievement and health. And with that, I'd like to conclude my greeting. Thank you.
Tomita sama, arigatou gozaimashita.
Thank you very much, Mr. Tomita. Next, we would like to introduce Dr. Ken Sakumura, Director of VLED. We'll give you some introduction about VLED. Well, thank you very much for coming to this symposium despite the very busy schedule. Mr. Shun Sakurai, as well as Mr. Koichi Endo, and as well as Mr. Kensuke Tomita, thank you very much for taking your time to come here to give us your greetings. The new founding of the organization, Vitalization Local Economy Organization by Open Data and Big Data. I am the director of this organization, VLED, and I would like to introduce this organization. On 14th of October, we have had the founding meeting, and this organization has been founded as a corporation. This organization, at the time of inception, had 9 members, founders. Mr. Hiromichi Shinohara as the Vice Chairman, and also Mr. Takaaki Shimizu, and also head of Mitsubishi Research Institute. I am asked him to act as advisor. And also, with regard to the name of this organization, as somebody have already mentioned, I have to look into my notes. Otherwise, I cannot tell you the official name in full size. VLED, the Vitalization of Local Economy Organization by Open Data and Big Data. And so this name carries our intention, Vitalization Local Economy Organization by Open Data and Big Data. And in short, we call it VLED. It doesn't include open data nor big data, but if we include them, that will be much longer name. The central government, local governments, and other public organizations do possess a variety of data, but such data should be used as open data. It should be distributed, it should be reused, so that we should be able to provide better services to the general public, as well as to help people to start their businesses and promote innovation. But towards this objective, what we have to do is as follows. We have to promote reuse of such data. Secondly, the data possessed by public organizations as well as private organizations, they should be merged up so that we should be able to provide open data environment to promote distribution of such. Lastly, by using full use of open data and big data, we should promote innovation. We used to have Open Data Promotion Consortium, which was founded in July 2012, and they have been doing their activities, and this consortium has been dissolved as of today, and all the activities of the consortium will be transferred to VLED, and members of the consortium has been transferred to VLED. With regard to governance, we have a committee, and we also have a committee to promote utilization of such data. By setting up this organization, there, we are thinking of new activities. One is in 2020, we will have Tokyo Olympics and Paralympics. We would like to take in that event as an opportunity to promote the usage of such data. And also, in order to have local economy vitalization, we would like to ask local government people to participate in the activities. In the area of architects, there are many qualifications, but in the area of IT, we do not have a fixed qualification levels, but information is so impacting on society, so that I think we should force the people who will be qualified as open data, big data activities. And in the computer area, you don't have to have a license to write a program. But by setting up new standards for qualification, it would be very easier for people to become one of them if they do have a challenge to take that qualification. It was only 3 years since we started to think about open data. But on a global level, we do already have G8 Open Data Charter, and I'm sure this open data will be a very important, vital element to change the world. By opening up data, you should be able to encourage a variety of innovation by opening up a number of data with less cost and with less money. So open data and big data should be fully used, and that's a very useful, effective means to support the people. At my lab, we have been involved in a variety of activities in the area of open data, and particularly we are very much aggressive in using open data and big data in the public transportation. And for example, in the subway network, we are thinking of using such data. We have done the application contest, and we have received so many applications to this contest of the 2,000 and 3,000, and then we have found 200 and 300 applications. Since this is the contest, I would like to make a very good judgment. This contest will give you some money to the winners. That's why we have so many applications. But anyway, there is a big awareness in society as a whole to the importance of open data and big data. So it's a big momentum. In the area of ICT, well, there was the breakthrough point where we can see a big jump in the awareness. I think in the area of open data, we are seeing a big rise in the interest in the people. But what we will do in the future is very important to keep such interest at a high level. We are at a very important point. I think it's very important to promote this concept of open and big data. And after this, we'll have the symposium, and I'm sure that we'll be having very active discussion in the area of actual use of open data and big data. And before concluding, I would like to solicit your further support to our activities. Thank you very much.